Hey everyone, in this video we are going to see design a full adder using suitable PROM PLD device. So basically we are using the programmable logic device to design the full adder. So before going to the actual design, first we will see what is mean by general PROM and what is the meaning of PLD, that is programmable logic device. Okay, so first we will see that one, then we will go for the design. So general structure of PROM is, so it consists of AND array, that is fixed one, and programmable OR array. So array is nothing but the number of lines, so where you can actually fuse some points and realize the combinational circuit equation, that is a Boolean expression. So here the AND array is fixed, that is you cannot program by your own, and you are only allowed to program the OR array here. So the manufacturer itself will be programming the AND array, and you are only allowed to program the OR array. So you can implement the type of expressions that are SOP, that is sum of product. So you can program the summation, that is ORing of the expressions is in your hand, but ANDing is in the hand of manufacturer. So that's why it is called as it is used to implement the SOP form of expressions. So the basic diagram just consists these two things. So here we will be having inputs, that is A, B up to N. So the complement of those will be taken and they are given to the AND array. So in turn AND array output will be given to the programmable OR array. So the work of user will be here, that is programmable OR array. So depending on our application or the Boolean expression, we will be fusing or crossing some points, that is basically fusing if we are considering in the real world, and according to that we will be getting the output here. So now coming to the full adder design, so let us see how we can design the full adder with the help of PLD device. So full adder, so it consists of two half adders. So this basic design we know. So first half adder is this one, and the second half adder is this one. The inputs for the first adder are the first half adder are A, B and C, and the output produced by the first half adder is S1, that is sum 1 and carry 1. So the C is not used for the first half adder, and then the next half adder consists of sum as its one of the input, and C, that is C in as the second input, and carry is directly propagated to the OR gate, which is at the end of this design. And from second half adder we will be getting sum directly, and the carry of that second adder is combined with the carry of the first adder. So these two carry when combined, that is C1 and C2 combined, will be giving the final carry. So we will be getting sum and carry for the three input variables A, B, C, and this design is this design consists of two half adder. So you can directly go for the single full adder, but it is better to use two half adder, so it will make our work simpler. So the functions which are used in this case are sum is equal to A XOR B XOR C. So when you draw the truth table and simplify with the help of KMap, we will be getting sum is equal to A XOR B XOR C, and carry will be equal to AB plus BC plus CA. Alright, so here we have got the truth table, that is ABC are the inputs and sum carry, these are the outputs. So there are totally 8 combinations, 000, 001, 010, 011, so up to 111. And when we add ABC, 0 plus 0 plus 0, the sum will be 0 and carry will be 0. So if you add 0 plus 0 plus 1, the sum will be 1 and carry will be 0. So if you add 010, again the sum will be 1, carry will be 0. So when the input contains two ones, the output will be, sum will be 0 because a carry will be generated here. So it is written as 01. And if it contains 100, then sum will be 1 and carry will be 0. So again, when the input contains two ones, that is A is 1 and C is also 1. So the output will be having sum is equal to 0 and carry is equal to 1 because the carry is generated here. So it will be written like this, sum is 0 here and carry is 1 here. So the form of that. And at the end we will be having if 111 is there, then the sum and carry both are 1. So this basic explanation we know, so we will not go in detail for that one. Okay, so the PLD design, actual PLD design is this one. So first we should understand this one. Okay, so these things we know, we have learnt in our engineering and other academics. So PLD design, inputs are, how much inputs are there? There are three inputs, A, B and C are the three inputs. And the maximum product terms which are possible with this is 8. So how I am writing 8 has got a formula. So let me just tell you. So 2 to the power 3 I am taking, because 2 to the power number of inputs is the formula for maximum product terms. So if you are having 3 inputs, then you have to take 2 to the power 3. So if you have 2 inputs, only A and B, then I have to take 2 to the power 2. At that time, the maximum number of product terms which are possible will be equal to 4 here. And the outputs we know, sum and carry are the 2 outputs. So I have written output is equal to 2. Alright, so how I can draw this one? And how I am pointing, so you can observe here, there are some dots and there are some crosses here. So why I am drawing exactly those things? So let us see. So first you just do one thing, you draw 8 AND gates here. So these are the 8 AND gates which indicates the maximum product terms. So I have got maximum product terms equal to 8. So I will be writing, I will be drawing first 8 AND gates here. So first one, second one, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, and this one is the 8th. So once we have drawn 8 AND gates, then draw the inputs in the horizontal manner, so with their complements also. So A is the input, draw it, and then draw the complement of A. Similarly, B is the input, draw it, then draw the complement of B, and as same as draw for C also. Okay, so once you have drawn A, B and C, so now you have to take two outputs, right? So there are two outputs, then draw two OR gates here. So this is the first OR gate, so you can see a OR gate over here, and this is the second OR gate, because you have got two outputs. So basically we will be having sum as the output here, and carry is the second output here. Okay, so what I will be doing is, these are the fixed AND gates, as I said, these cannot be changed. So see the truth table, A has got first 0, 0, 0 and 0. First 4 terms of the A are 0. So I will not solder at the first 4 terms, that is 1, 2, 3 and 4. These I have left as it is. And the next 4 terms are having 1, 1, 1 and 1. So I have to solder here. So I have soldered here, here, here and here. So this indicates the 5th, 6th, 7th and 8th position of the AND gate. Okay, so similarly, A bar will be the complement of A. So wherever I have left, just solder those things. So I am left for the first 4 positions. So first, solder those first 4 positions here. So first one, second one, third one and the fourth. So if I have done soldering here, so leave that, because these are the complement to each other. And similarly for B, you can see here, first 2 terms are 0, 0. So I should not solder first 2 points here, that is this one and this one. And the second 2 terms are 1, 1. So I have to solder the second 2 terms. So this third and fourth I have soldered. Again, it is 0, 0. So leave these 2 points, and then again, it is 1, 1. So solder these 2. And again, you have to draw the complement. So whenever we have left blank, we just solder at the complement side. So here I have not soldered, then solder it here. Here I have not soldered, solder it here. So here I have soldered, then leave this. So similarly do for the rest of the things, that is B and C in. So once you have done with this one, so your half work is over, that is fixed AND array you have created. Then go for programmable OR array. So programmable OR array is nothing but, we are actually now depending on our application or the boolean function, we are making the circuit to work. So sum has so see the sum table. So sum has got 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 up to 7. So 1, 2, that is for 1th position it is high, for 2nd position it is high, for 4th position it is high, and for 7th position it is high. So whatever are the high positions, that is corresponding to the digital value, that is decimal value here, you just solder those things. So for AND gate we are indicating with the help of dot, and for OR gate we are making a cross. So this is the standard rule which you are using in VLSI. So I am having sum as equal to 1 for those positions, 1, 2, and 4 and the last position is 7. So I will solder at 1, 2, 4 and 7. So I will be getting sum here. So this is the OR of all those things. So I will be getting A XOR B XOR C. Okay, so from this table itself it is derived. So I am directly soldering this table on the FPGA board here. And for carry, I am having third position as high, fifth, sixth and seventh position as high. So third position I will cross here, that is basically soldering or making the fuse on. And then fifth, sixth and seventh I have soldered here. So I will be getting a carry that is equal to AB plus BC plus CA. So like this, we can device or program a logical device here with the help of fixed AND array and programmable OR array. So I hope you like this video. Please guys, hit the like button, and if you are new, please subscribe the channel. Thank you. Thanks for watching.